Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Annex for North Main tonight here at the middle school. You're in for an amazing concert tonight. I'm Mr. Cotto, I'm the building principal. I believe Mr. Davis is in the back there. He's taking care of the back of the auditorium tonight, our assistant principal, and we are welcoming you here tonight. Like I said, you're in for an incredible show tonight. We had the opportunity to hear the fifth grade today perform for the fourth grade. They do that in our in North Main. We kind of squeeze everybody in there to have a full performance, which is really nice. But they are incredible. They are a large group, if you haven't noticed that already, so the sound is going to be wonderful. A couple housekeeping things. So if there is an emergency tonight and the alarm does go off, please exit the auditorium. There's two exits in the back and two exits in the front, and you'll exit the building, and you'll stay out there until it's the off air and we'll come back in. If you have young children and they're getting a little restless, since this is not my building, feel free to take in the halls and run to your heart's content. It's a very big building, second floor, lots of space to go. Years ago, if you ever went to this building as a high school, you know they actually ran track upstairs on the second floor, but now I'm dating myself. So without further ado, our orchestra tonight, under the conduction of Mrs. Hotto, I'm going to announce our concert mistress, Emma Greckey.
Hi, good evening. I have had the pleasure now of working with these kids. I was telling them for 15 months at this point, and they were all nervous in the back, and they were like, I'm so scared, what if we make a mistake? And they're sounding really good, and I'm so proud of you guys. You have done such a great job, so far tonight. If you haven't noticed, I do have a few high school music mentors who come down once or twice a week, and they help out with kids who are struggling or kids who are excelling, or they fill in for instruments that I just don't have. And I have Celeste and Andrew from the high school on stage. I have Kathy in the viola section. And I have Valeria in the violin. Really great big thank you to the fifth grade team who has been so gracious with their time. We have extra rehearsals and they help these kids when they get down to lessons. And to you guys for signing those practice charts and making sure that they have their stuff and that they're prepared, and for not deleting all of the emails that I send home on a regular basis. A big thank you to Mr. Cotto and Mr. Davis, who are always so supportive of this program, and of course my two colleagues, Ms. Torello and Ms. Voltaggio, who are just such a pleasure and joy to work with. Our last piece is Fancy Fiddles. Have a wonderful holiday season, and thank you for coming out tonight.
Here, Poker.
Okay, I'm going to take a minute while they're actually resetting for the band. The Moosey Boosters are out in the hallway right outside here to my left, your right. They are doing a raffle, a winter concert series raffle, where the winner will receive an Xbox Series X. The drawing is actually this Thursday. Tickets are $5 each, 3 for 10, 8 for 20. You can see them when you walk out the door when you leave tonight, if you're interested. That's my public service announcement. That's all I got. I always get these chances to have a captive audience. Everyone's here. You're not going anyplace until they're done, so I get to talk to you for a couple seconds. Just a little word about our music department. So, a couple things you're going to find out tonight, if you don't already know that. Obviously, the fifth grade chorus, which we'll see last, is a very large chorus because the entire grade level is in it, unlike any other elementary school in our district. You also heard that this is Hanna and this is Torella. We'll talk in a minute about our high school students that come back to work with our elementary students. First of all, they're North Mainers, so they're North Main graduates, so to speak, and they're coming back to support us. They do that on their own time after school. Obviously, their day is ended, so they're volunteering that time, and they have to get picked up by parents at the end of that time because the buses aren't going to take home the high school students on the elementary buses. So they are giving a tremendous amount of their time to us, and there are a lot of them. They walk in the building and I have to take double takes because they're actually as tall as I am now at this point, and it's just incredible to see them, but it is a cool experience. I believe we're the only building in the district right now that is doing that, and we love it. We truly love it. So a round of applause to our guys. So So, I'm watching the wave to the parents in the back. I love that. I always get a reminder that if you're videotaping tonight, please remember that when you have your cell phone up and you're videotaping, the person behind you doesn't really want to just see your child in the phone, so kind of hold it down a little bit, or feel free to move around to the sides, to the center of the aisles. No fire inspector here tonight. We're safe. It's okay. So without further ado, this is Lara Torello and our fifth grade band.
Thank you. you very much. We have one more piece to close out the band portion of our concert. And after the band is done, the fifth grade chorus is going to conclude our fifth grade winter concert this evening. So please sit tight, enjoy the rest of our band performance, and chorus will be out shortly. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, our chorus is coming in about 2 minutes, but again, another little public service announcement. Just, we're in the middle of winter here with the weather and so forth changing. It seems like every other day, you know that. I know there's a couple days coming up where the weather's going to be so-so. I'm just reminding everybody, keep tabs on whether it's email, phone, however you have it, the alert set for you for dismissals or 2 hour delays. And we're also talking about 2 hour delays. Mr. David's asking to remind everybody. So I'm not trying to be sarcastic or offend anybody, but 2 hours means 2 hours. It doesn't mean that, oh, I can drop them off now at 8:30 because it works in my 2 hour window. So our normal school day starts at 9. The 2 hour delay would be a 11 o'clock arrival. Because if you drop them off earlier than that, we really, A, don't know if they're going to have somebody in the building because our staff is coming down at 11. B, our custodial staff at our ground school could still be clearing the parking lot and taking care of the sidewalks at 9:30 in the morning, 10 o'clock in the morning. It could still be happening, and I really want to make sure the children are safe. So we have to watch those 2 hour delays. But also the early dismissals, keep in tune for those. Make sure you have an alternate plan. Because every student's got to go home on an early dismissal, and I get nervous when I have a pickup that's set up for an early dismissal and the parents don't show, and do I put them on a bus? Do I wait for parents to come? So worst case scenario, make sure you're by your phone, and we will call you and make sure you're on your way. We know parents get stuck in traffic. We will not send a kid, you know, we'll not leave a kid out in the front on the, you know, on the bench and go home. Don't worry, we will do that. But please make sure you have those plans for the winter and the weather. This week is probably a ton of holiday parties in your children's classes, I know that. So just think about that when you send in anything, if the teachers ask for stuff, kind of follow the guidelines along the way. I promise they'll probably go home Thursday and buy a sugar duck. I'm just telling you that. I wish I could say there's no sugar in the building, but there is. It's just the way it is. It's Christmas, it's the holidays, it's the week off, it's everything. So they're gonna be in a good mood. They're gonna probably get a lot of tests on Wednesday and Thursday, and then Friday will be a fun day to finish up the week. And we'll probably come home with lots of stuff, I'm sure. Are we ready, Ms. Fantasio? Okay, the chorus is gonna come in now. 45 fifth graders. That's pretty impressive. And they got up in the driveway, that's right, give me a round. It's kind of like Persian passing. So there is no better way to start the holiday week, whatever you're celebrating, than the beautiful music you just heard and to hear these. I use the word angelic, and they are. They are angelic voices that you're about to hear. There's no better way to start the holiday season. So without further ado, our fifth grade chorus and the introduction of Mrs. Barbara Montagno with the assistance of Mrs. Hotto and Mrs. Harrell.
Your eyes, no, and silencio, and I. Bye.
So, if you remember when we started tonight, or even before when I said there's, you know, these angelic voices, I told you it for a rare treat. Speaking from experience, I think there's probably two jobs in the world that are the most rewarding, more rewarding than any other job ever. One, without a doubt, is being a parent. That is obviously the most rewarding job in the world, and it is a job, believe me, I know that. The other one is being an educator. We get to spend our days with these beautiful children and walk by music rooms, walk by classrooms, and hear those voices all day long. There is no better job in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great holiday, be safe, and wait for the fifth graders to exit before you exit, please.